give them a little smoke, get them back down the high. Got a few bees on the inner cover. We'll lay this real easy right here. Got some dead bees. Most of the bees are going to be on the inner cover. They build their comb from the inside out. We'll go ahead and remove one frame from the outside to give them more room. Real careful not to mash any bees. And they are very, very, very active today. So we're going to move this frame right here. Being really careful not to mash any bees. You can see on this frame they're already starting to work a little bit, building some comb. What the smoke does, it gets them down in the hive and calms them down. We're going to lift this frame up with a queen box on it. And as you can see, they're building a lot of comb in here. And they're really waiting for this queen bee to get out. But we want to still be very careful on letting them out too quick. If we release her too quick, they will kill her. Give a little smoke. We'll kind of look what they're doing, but they're really building good comb in this hive. Now I'm gonna look at the next frame. Being really careful not to mash any bees. go slowly. Slide this next frame over, being very careful not to mash any beads. Get out of the way. This is the frame right next to the queen cage. You can see this white right here, they're starting to build comb up so she'll have a place to lay her eggs and store honey. We're gonna move them off this little white thing they've built, and we're gonna remove that. A little bit of burr comb right up here in the middle. Real careful not to mash any, because if you mash one, they emit a pheromone that attracts the other bees to come and can be very aggressive. So we're going to get this burr comb off this top frame right here. Wax. And they're starting to really draw this frame up very nicely. As you can see the white in the frame, they're drawing it up so she'll have a place to lay. So I'm going to go ahead and get the queen and do a slow release. Go ahead and remove the cork from this end of the queen cage. I'm going to still make sure she's in there. You can see the queen cage is right here. Give them a few puffs of smoke. The queen is still alive in this hive. That's a good thing. So I'm going to go ahead and remove the cork from the candy end so they can slowly eat through that and release her. Get my knife. Being very careful not to mash any bees. Maybe easier if I go ahead and set this frame back in and do it that way. You only want to remove the cork from the candy end to do a slow release. And I'm going to help them out a little bit, and I'm going to make a little hole through the candy, so they won't have as much trouble releasing. You want to be very careful that you don't poke the queen bee. While you're doing that, mm-hmm. go ahead and put this frame in. In about 3 days, we'll come back and check on them and see what they've done. As you can see right here, this is the queen cage. She's in there. She's the bigger one. And this is the candy hen right here, and they'll eat through that to release her. Here's a bee right here, and they've already started to make these combs high off the frame, so she'll have a place to lay her eggs. And this worker bee right here has his little head in one of them, making wax foundation to build it up so she can lay her eggs. So I'm going to go ahead and put her back in. Being careful not to mash any bees. We'll slide these frames over. Go ahead and smoke them one more time. And we need to go ahead and get this top back on this cage, because they're getting a little irritated at me. Put this inner cover on, being very careful not to mash any of the bees underneath, if it can help. And that's hive number one, and I'm going to go to the second hive in just a second.